हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो द न्यू टॉपिक इज फैटिग डिजाइन अंडर कंबाइंड स्ट्रेसेस। नाउ व्हाट वी हैव सीन हियर, एक्चुअली टिल डेट वी हैव सीन दैट द डिजाइन ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स सब्जेक्ट टू फ्लक्चुएटिंग एक्सियल लोडिंग, बेंडिंग एंड टॉर्शनल लोडिंग। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ मॉडिफाइड गुड डायग्राम, द कंपोनेंट विच इज सब्जेक्टेड टू आइदर एक्सियल लोडिंग और बेंडिंग मूवमेंट और टॉर्शनल मूवमेंट। सो फॉर ईच टाइप्स ऑफ लोडिंग separate mean and separate stresses are amplitude is generated. So now here, if in the real world problem what happens, the axial loading, the bending stresses, the torsional stresses, all these things come in a combined manner. So due to this, what happened, this results in two or three dimensional stresses. So this two and three dimensional stresses is difficult to solve with a single theory of failure, but one theory of failure is there which help us to solve, and it is the distortion energy theory. So this theory gives us this formula to solve a three dimensional stresses problem, where sigma x, sigma y, sigma z are the normal stresses in x, y, z, tau x, y, tau y, z, tau z, x, z are the shear stresses in the same planes, x, y and z planes. And sigma is what the stress, which is the equivalent stress. Now, if two dimensional stress is there, then what happened? Then sigma z, tau xy, tau yz, tau xz is zero. So you will get a previous equation will become this. Now, for mean and for amplitude stresses, this will, you will get a mean stress in this way. You will get an amplitude stress with the help of these formulas. Now the two stresses, that is sigma m and sigma a, which you get from the above equation. Now in case of combined bending and torsion movement, there is a normal stress sigma x accompanied by the torsional shear stress. So equation is given by these terms. Now let's find out a mean and the amplitude stress for these equations. So sigma xm and sigma xa are the mean and the amplitude stress for tau xy, tau xm and tau xy. So this equation will become, mean stress will be in this manner and amplitude stress will be in this manner. So this is how the fluctuating fatigue design under combined stresses works. Thank you very much.